What is going on, y'all? So y'all might recognize the setting. I'm in Zach's garage. I'm still not doing too much. I have to make him a list of the stuff that he has to order for all this fueling stuff. He didn't get to order that yet because I didn't make the list yet. So I'm not touching that. I'm really not doing too much today. I did more like overlooking everything. So what we're chasing after right now is the harness. We found that the knock sensor is not connected yet, so we got to put that in. We're probably going to have to take the intake off and a whole bunch of the stuff. I don't think we're going to get to that necessarily this week. Possibly, are you free tomorrow? Yeah, I don't think I'm going to be free, but we'll see. If I'm here tomorrow, you guys get to see the next clip that I'll be trying to take this intake off and everything like that, but I don't think it's going to be this week. The other stuff that we found, we also found the AACV back there that connected to one of the connectors. I have to chase down the pin out as well because this has a lot of aftermarket stuff. So some of the connectors are not all being used. So I'm gonna have to check out the pin out, figure out which of these sensors are each. I'm trying to eliminate as many as possible by connecting up as many as possible. We still have to reconnect the alternator. We have to put the, I don't know if it's the positive or the ground, but one of those has to go into the alternator. We have this stuff. I believe this goes to the front. I'm not quite sure. We got a hose that this should fit. We still got to cut it. So for now, we're just still looking over stuff and trying to figure more stuff out. And I think you want to do this hose now. So we makeshift this hose and it's actually fitting pretty well. We got to trim it a little bit, but we'll get to that. And then we got to put coolant in the car, but that's going to wait until we get this harness done so we don't have coolant all over the place if we have to take it off to do something else. All right, so obviously I'm here. We're doing the intake now. It looks like 8/12. I gotta take off these clips that go the harness to the fuel injectors. There's a few other things that, you know, will come loose. I'm not really too worried about it as long as I can just kind of fold this out of the way and then get that knock sensor on. Yes, I believe you could do it with this on, but this is just mad extra, and plus it's gonna let us see a lot of the other harness. I still have to do more research on figuring out where this other plugs are, but maybe we'll be able to see stuff. We got to see the IACV, so that we found the spot for that, but there's still a lot of plugs that are loose, and there are a lot of plugs that we might or may not need. So I'm gonna get to taking this off and then I'm gonna cut back to that. So we're getting somewhere now. This intake is way simpler than the JZ, man. I like this. This is nice and easy to get in here and work on this. It's literally these 8 bolts and then it comes off. So it should be under here somewhere is where I'm looking for the knock sensor. So I got to bolt that in. Oh wait, maybe over here. I'm just feeling around right now to try to figure out where it's at. Oh, there's a hole here. This is probably where it goes right here.
As of now, I'm chasing this harness. I'm super confused. So like I told you guys, as long as I did this back in the day, so this is a lot of like old style tech stuff in the sense where like ECUs were old school and things weren't as digitized. Everything was really analog and things like that. So I followed this harness. I'm trying to figure out what this harness is. I don't know anything about SR, so I'm learning as I go. All I'm seeing on this side on the pictures and the forums is that there's a knock sensor, a coolant temp sensor, the starter, and that's pretty much it. There's like one other thing that's for the battery, I believe, but I'm seeing very few things on both sides. So for me, I'm used to the 2J stuff. It's got a lot of sensors on each side. It's got oil pressure, etc., etc., like, you know, power steering, a whole bunch of other stuff. This one has power steering, but it's on that side. So I'm trying to figure out where this harness is and where it's coming from and if we even need it. Now I followed some of the wires and some of them go to the alternator. The alternator, I believe, does it have a second connector on here? It's got this one. It's got another one for the power there. Yep. And then I thought I saw another one that was brown or something. No, I'm not seeing anything else. But point being is we can see these wires go there, and then we can see that this wires go to the starter. So that leaves us with all these wires which go to this hub harness. And now I have to follow all of those wires. I gotta figure out what this pin out is. I could do that here, right? The problem with that is this is faded. So I gotta look up a photo of this, figure out where all of this is and where these pin out to, because then that'll tell me exactly what this sub harness is supposedly to. Now, Zach's telling me that the KA harness, a lot of people convert it to the SRs. So I have to figure out if that's the case, if that this is an extra harness from the KA that they didn't need, or if stuff was converted, or if, you know, et cetera, et cetera. So I'm going to be chasing that now. But I can see in everything, and, you know, I can reach everything. So this is becoming less overwhelming. But we still have a lot of looking to do online and figuring out where all this stuff goes, as well as wrapping up a lot of these wires that are loose and just finishing unfinished work. But I'm going to get back to checking this out. And it looks like this is pretty much going to be it for today, guys. I know it's a short one, but this is where I'm at. I'm lost. I'm learning. I'm figuring this all out as I go. So you guys are learning with me. Some of you guys might know more than I do. And if you do, comment. But this is where we're at. We still have to order stuff for the fuel regulator stuff. What else do we need to order? We had to order crush washers for the turbo drain fittings. And then that hose, we still have to get those clamps for that hose. We didn't touch any of that up yet. Again, we're just trying to do it step by step and take it little by little. It's not going to happen overnight. With that being said, guys, I hope you guys enjoyed this week. Peace out. This is exciting. So, I don't know, I got the brand. I don't want to talk about it that much because there's still things I want to do and develop on it, but I'm just going to make cool stuff for now that I like. And if y'all like it, y'all can get it. I don't have a second leverage right now, so that's why I'm cutting kind of funny. But this is exciting. Oh, yeah, I see it. All right. These are probably like 50 of them. Obviously, it's like 49 because I'm going to take one. Yeah. Look. It's got the green on the bottom. And then I think that's a, and a big old smiley on it. It actually came out really, really good. So, if you want one, it should be on the site soon. Okay, so, yeah, I just showed you guys these. I'm sitting here with my cat. He was being Mr. Needy, but so what's going on now is I told you guys I need to figure out, I need to send him all the stuff to order. That's fueling, crush washers, bands for the coolant hoses. There's a few other things. It's AN lines. I do have some at my garage that I have to go pick up. I haven't been to my garage because I still have that other Lexus in there. I still have to test a few things on that. Still needs tires. So that car's been sitting, which means that I don't have space for my car right now. Hence why we haven't been seeing the SC. I know, that's probably what you guys are here for. Don't worry. I promise this next week we'll be doing stuff on the SC as well. Hopefully the S14. I need to get parts for the S14 before we can move forward with that. Like I said, I'm chasing the harness down. If I get any progress on that, then I'll report on that next week. And then for now, if I remember, I'll do a cold start for you guys with the SC. That exhaust is, it's still crunchy, it's still coming loose. So hopefully next week I have the other Lexus out of the garage and I can start building the new one. It's not going to be done yet because I still have to get a muffler for that car. But I do have a big boy resonator, and that should quiet up the car quite a bit and give it more tone versus loudness, and hopefully take out the drone completely. Right now I'm seeing drone because I don't have it completely sealed, because when it was sealed, I didn't have any drone. So I'm really, really hoping that that changes the game for that. I will update you guys on that. I'll give you a little bit of info because I did get a 45 angle that changes the angle of the header that coming out. But it's a flange to a flange to another flange. And what I mean by that is you have the header with the flange, and then a flange goes to that with the 45. And on the end of that 45, there's another flange to bolt to the resonator that has a flange on it. The reason I'm doing it that way is because I know the flanges I've been holding. I know it's potentially creating an area for the exhaust to leak, but it's better than my crunchy welds.
I'm really not good at welding stainless. I have to learn. I have to do my due diligence and get a setup that's going to work for that, because that will make it 1,000 times better if I can do it that way. I really don't like the sound of stainless. Believe it or not, I feel like, maybe I'm wrong, but I do feel like the mild steel has a different tone to it, and it sounds more stock, so to speak. And I like that better than the stainless. So I'm trying to do the whole exhaust not stainless. If I can find a 45 that's not stainless, granted my headers are stainless, there's nothing I can do about that. I'm not going to change that. But yes, so that's where hopefully we'll be doing next week. Excuse my English, I'm talking all crazy, I understand. But, you know, the point is the information is getting across. So yes, fingers crossed, SD next week, exhaust next week. It's not going to be a complete exhaust, it's going to be pieces putting together. Maybe I'll try it out, because I'm going to have to put it up to fit it up and see how it fits and see if it works. Because this one is like, it's a 2.5 inch out, but it's probably like 3, maybe 4 inches around. It'll definitely fit under there, but it's just about how much I'm going to be rubbing. And then this time I'm going to try to go after the trans mount, take the curve after the trans mount, because right now I'm still crunched on the trans mount. And now that my suspension's settling in, I'm scraping that exhaust a little bit more. And that's probably what's killing the welds on the exhaust. They're not good welds, so that's really what it is. But what I'm saying is that it's making it worse by hitting it all the time on the ground. So be excited for that next week. I know I still have to do the coilover review. You've been hearing about me saying it every week, except to do the trans review. Again, it's got a lot going on. I'm trying to change the setting for you guys. And then I also wanted to show you this before I go. And yes, I will try to get the cold start. So, as you can see, we got the tongue, we got the midnight octane.co. I will be posting these on the site soon. I've been slow, as you guys can see. So, you know, just expect them soon. Keep checking out. The whole point of this is the whole smiles per gallon campaign. That's a big motto of ours on the Midnight Octane brand. So, I mean, this is pretty straightforward. It's a mask, got the smiley on it. It's yellow. You can roll it up into a beanie. I know it's late in the season. I came late to the game. I'll be having more cool stuff come out. I'll be doing more novelty stuff where it's just random car stuff or product. Basically, it's a streetwear brand, things like that. Just doing whatever I want to do. Maybe we'll get hard goods. Maybe we'll get some automotive stuff. But in due time, guys, just little by little. And, you know, I appreciate you guys. Keep supporting the brand. Keep supporting the YouTube. That helps big time. It gives me feedback. It makes me want to do it more. It gives me motivation. I appreciate you guys, the ways you guys have been supporting. With that being said, peace out. And I will see you guys next week. All right, here's the cold start for y'all.